Understand, China's statement is based on the 2021 Coast Guard Law, which they passed effective 01 February 2021. China's approach through lawfare is not only being felt by the Philippines, it's also being done in the East China Sea against Japan and against South Korea. We expect the same also with Vietnam soon. After passing such a law, China will remain silent. And then they could threaten implementing that law. That is what is happening right now in the West Philippine Sea when they stated that they will start arresting fishermen intruding into their own territory. I would like to emphasize the statement of our Commander-in-Chief. This is totally unacceptable. First and foremost, it has no basis in international law. It has already been ruled by the arbitral tribunal that the 9-dash line does not have any legal entitlements. Hence, any action by the Chinese Coast Guard is illegal. It is unacceptable. The guidance is we will just continue performing our mandate of ensuring the integrity of the national territory, protecting the Filipinos, and securing or protecting our sovereignty. It will not deter us from performing our mandate.
Follow up, sir.
Just to be unequivocal, paprotektahan ng AFP kapag may nangyaring sa ating mga mangingisda doon.
When we say the AFP will protect, there are many ways how to do that. Number one, it is not purely a military action. It will entail a whole of government, whole of nation approach to ensure that every Filipino is protected, not only on land, but more importantly for this particular case in the maritime domain.
Thank you. Any other questions? Clarification. Okay. Lady Cabernet of the Daily Tribune.
In case that China would do such, may mga plano na po ba tayo ang AFP?
Could you go back to the first part of your statement?
In case China would do such thing na to arrest Filipino fishermen in our Philippine waters?
As we have always been emphasizing, the AFP lives on plans. So we have a lot of plans. If the situation arises based on the plan, then we know what to do. So rest assured that we have a lot of contingency plans, not only for this particular incident, but for a range of incidents that may happen.
Any other follow-up on that particular issue? Marlene Pagliano sa Bombo Radio. Ay, recognized Marlene Pagliano sa Bombo Radio.
Hi, sir. Good morning po. Sir, magkatagtag pa tayo ng deployment ang Philippine Navy sa West Philippine Sea kasi dahil sa possible threat po na itulot ng panibagong policy ng China po para protektahan yung mga Filipino fishermen po doon sa area.
Magbabago ba ng deployment?
Magbabago or magdadagdag po ba ng deployment, sir, for the sacred po ng ating...
The pronouncement of China was given after the ating ito caravan. And it was constructed in such a way that it would be in effect in Bajo de Masinloc. So we have not seen any pronouncement from their side that will cover the 8 or 9 features of the West Philippine Sea. So, nevertheless, our plans for West Philippine Sea are still there. We still continue to rotate and to resupply our personnel.
So, sir, in short po, hindi po tayo mag-deploy. Maintain lang po yung kung ilan yung bilang po ng ating deployment po doon sa...
Our deployment, our plans are proactive. They are dynamic. We react to situations, sometimes they change, sometimes they don't. So depending on the situation. But so far, our deployment, our force in the West Philippine Sea is still constant.
Pwede niyo ba, sir, i-share po sa amin kung ilan po yung average deployment po ng ating mga barko po doon sa amin?
Allow me to answer you in this way. Tagaluhin ko na lang. Mahigit ko mulang. Yung ating mga tao sa bawat detachment.
Mahigit ko mulang na.
More or less.
Na.
Hanggang doon lang muna.
I think more of what being said is that it will already be in touch with operational security of the deployments of our personnel in the area. So rest assured, the maritime domain awareness patrols or maritime patrols are being conducted regularly by the Philippine Navy. And of course, to include with our Philippine Air Force, nakalimutan ko, meron pa tayong air patrol sa air patrol on that part. So I think that would best answer your question, Marlene. So nauna si Joy. Let's hear it from Joy Cantos.
Sir, good morning, sir.
Also to recognize Joy Cantos being present.
Sir, good morning po. Sir, were you aware of the 2013 agreement with regards to the Ayong Seoul, yung resupply mission? It was disclosed yesterday by no less than by Executive Secretary Mijardea that the status quo was happened during the term of late President Aquino, and it was between then Secretary Volker Gasmin and the Chinese diplomat that there would be just a resupply mission, and there would be no repair that would happen there, otherwise they will be bombarded with water cannons. May ganun po bang agreement talaga, sir? Kasi wala daw pong alam si na XNA Esperon, Lorenzana with regards to the gentleman's agreement, and rather nagkaroon ng finger pointing parang blank, ano na to, sir?
We stand by the pronouncement of the President. No such agreement is in existence. If there is any, it has already been rescinded. I call it a zombie story na dapat patayin na natin kasi ito ay galing sa kanila. Hindi naman ito galing sa atin.
Eh, sir, bakit tinuturo po si ex-Defense Secretary Gasmin at saka yung diplomat? Doon daw po yung agreement, hindi sa kanila.
We have to be very careful in picking up the narrative from the other side, because a lot of this is designed to sow dissent with among us na tayo mismo mag-away-away.
Yes, that's a second follow-up, Joy.
Do you have plan to dry dock the BRP Sierra Madre? Parang makita ko sa video, sir, it's crumbling, may kinakalawang na po siya.
Yeah, it has been said many times that it's crumbling and it will not last long. Nandun pa naman siya.
Chinese vessels sa area. Bakit parang dumami ulit po?
Yes, if we notice, the increase of 30 based on our monitoring is in Bajo de Masinloc, and this coincided with the Atin Ito caravan. So it was a reaction on China's side to the Atin Ito caravan.
Okay, thank you very much. Next question to be by Patrick Deso, PTV4.
Very good.
Sir.
Check.
Pakilapit na lang yung mic.
Sir, kamusta yun lang namin yung mga tropa doon sa BRP Sierra Madre? Yung last resupply po, I think late March pa po. Ano? Yun pa yung water cannon yung unayos na paper. So yun nga, kailan yung planong magkaroon ulit ng next narore, and kamusta po yung welfare ng ating mga tropa doon, given the fact nga po na almost 2 months na po after the
Thank you for asking that question. Yung mga tropa natin, hindi lamang sa BRP Sierra Madre, but all over the West Philippine Sea, to include the Northern Islands, mataas ang moral nila. And details on the RORE, we leave it up to the Western Command on the schedule on how, when, and where ang kanilang resupply and reprovision. It's at the level of the Western Command and Naval Forces West. But rest assured, mataas ang moral ng ating mga tropa.
Yung
another follow-up, yes?
Yung supply sila, sir, enough pa po ba? May sufficient attempt ba na even through airdrop recently?
There are many options available on the table. The operational mix is at the call of the Commander Western Command to Naval Forces West. So I believe it is safe to assume that the people there are rotated on time, the supplies are still sufficient. It's part of the concern of the operational commander.
Pero sir, specifically doon sa mga tropa sa BRP Sierra Madre, wala pa bang urgent request for their supplies to be na matagtagan?
Hindi naman tayo umaabot sa point na magre-request ang tropa. So activities like that are monitored at the level of the operational commander kung kinakailangan, how, when, and where.
Okay, thank you very much, Patrick. Last, do you have any last question? Okay, last question.
Last na lang, sir. Si former AFP Western Command Chief Vice Admiral Carlos po nasa Senate hearing ngayon. As lang kami ng statement, sir, sa AFP, he denied na nagkaroon ng agreement, but he confirmed na merong phone conversation, but walang consent na i-record po yun.
I'll have to check on the latest updates on the committee hearings sa Senate.
Thank you very much, Patrick. Next to be questions, Victor Reyes, Malaya.
Sir, sir, in the event...
Pakilapit na lang yung mic.
Sir, in the event na ituloy ng China yung pag-arrest ng fishermen that is West Philippine Sea. Do you see this leading to an armed conflict?
In the event that it will be implemented, I don't want to speculate. Rest assured that we have a range of options available based on our contingency plans.
Sir, 12 years of, it has been already 12 years since China to gain control of Scarborough. May mga noted bank constructions sila doon.
There were reports of having some pipes spotted underwater, but we are still confirming this, and rest assured the National Task Force of West Philippine Sea will come out with a pronouncement once confirmed.
Wala rin observations about reclamation.
So far, wala naman.
Sir, i-follow up pa rin yung sabi ni Patrick. Sir, kung kinonfirm ni Admiral Carlos yung conversation, was this sanctioned by the military leadership?
No.
The guidance is that, AFP Pao.
Basically, this is happening just right now, no? So we still have to get the particular details on what really transpired during the Senate hearing. Maybe that will be the topic for our next discussions. Thank you very much. We'll give you a posted and updated on that particular issue. Sir, next questions is, I think John Eric is raising. Yes. And then after that will be Robina Esquito.
Yes, sir. Morning. Quick follow-up. Nung last week, sir, sa ating ito, may sinabi sila na may pipe, sir, sa loob ng Scarborough Show. Do we have any info on that? And may, kung meron, sir, anong possible course of action, sir, ng Philippine Navy?
Thank you, sir. We are still awaiting the results of the confirmation. So I don't want to preempt any possible action, not unless we have confirmation.
So, sir, inimbestigahan na po natin itong development. Are we investigating, sir?
We're awaiting the confirmation.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay, Robina.
Ay, sir, regarding dun sa new regulation ng China, can we at least give assurance to our Filipino fishermen that the Philippine Navy will not allow China or Chinese Coast Guard to arrest them? Kasi I'm sure it will have chilling effect dun sa mga Filipino fishermen. And we encourage them na mamangisda dun sa mga area na yun to at least assert our sovereign rights, diba po?
Not only the Philippine Navy, but the entire government, the entire nation will not allow this based on the pronouncement of our Commander-in-Chief that this is totally unacceptable. It is not only a pronouncement given to us, it's also given to Japan and South Korea with the dynamics with China. But rest assured that the Philippine Navy supports the call of the Commander-in-Chief. This is unacceptable. It is not in accordance with international law. It has no basis. It has already been nullified by the Arbitral Tribunal 8 years ago in 2016.
Tapos, sir, follow-up lang dun sa pipe na nakita sa Scarborough. Don't you think it's late na na-monitor natin na nandun naka-install na yung mga pipes na yun? Are we not able to at least monitor yung installation or yung movement?
That's the subject of the confirmation right now.
Alright.
Kino-confirm pa yan kasi we're not taking that report na meron. If you say na too late na, it's as if admitting na meron. That's why I mentioned earlier, we're awaiting confirmation.
Sir, can you share paano kino-confirm yung ganitong klase ng movement ng Chinese or ng activity nila?
Yung sa pipe?
Yes po.
Maraming paraan.
Like?
Maraming paraan. How to confirm a report?
Like? Can you give us an example, sir?
You could send out a ship, you could use aircraft, you could use satellite tracking. Maraming paraan.
Alright.
You could leverage our partners and allies. Mm-hmm. So maraming paraan.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, Robina. I think that's all about it from the... Any further questions to West Philippine Sea? If there are no more further... Okay. Bianca Daba, EBS.
Morning po. Sir, balik lang doon kay Vice Admiral Carlos po. With all these developments, sir, yung AFP po ba, yung Philippine Navy, is planning to initiate an investigation into these allegations po kay Vice Admiral Carlos?
I will base my statement not on what's happening this morning, kasi sabi nga ni AFP pa, hindi pa natin alam ano mga pinag-usapan. But the guidance of the National Task Force of West Philippine Sea is that there will be no investigation, no need.
Bakit, sir, no need po, sir?
statement.
Hindi kailangan eh.
I think that was a statement of the NSA chair, no? That there will be no probe on that particular aspect that was issued already. So as of now, yun po yung ating panel. But on the development of the stories, we will also be dependent on that one, of the actions of the armed forces. Thank you, Bianca. I think that, okay, last questions. Okay, last two questions. Generic.
Saan ever po na mapatunayan na may installation sila, sir? Anong batas ang nalabag sila ng China dun sa kanilang action? Sa pipe po.
As to the legal violations, I have to check on that, but I don't want to speculate yet, right now, on the future actions to be conducted. We're just awaiting the confirmation.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
From the Inquirer. This is for Colonel Padilla and to Commodore Trindad. In the AFP's statement over the weekend, released by the POW chief and the AFP spokesperson, it said that changes in the leadership and key positions within the military is necessary for the institution to adapt evolving security environment and effectively address emerging challenges. Does this mean that Vice Admiral Carlos is no longer effective in addressing emerging challenges, such as his job of overseeing the West Philippine Sea? And does this mean that he has already lost the trust and confidence of the AFP leadership? That's why there was a need for him to be replaced.
What's your question?
So, does this mean that Vice Admiral Carlos is no longer effective in performing his job, particularly in overseeing the West Philippine Sea? And by him being replaced by the AFP, wala na bang tiwala? Did he lose the trust? Confidence to the AFP leadership?
Sure, if I may share. I think that was the let's put context on the statement particularly given. No? The question was in the initial that we issued that particular statement, is that bakit pinalitan si Admiral Carlos, and why the sudden from an acting capacity into a full capacity, you know, ni Rear Admiral Torres Jr. to occupy the particular position. Yun yung naging content natin doon of that particular aspect, because Vice Admiral Carlos is still on leave. So for a long period of being staying on leave, we need to put in a permanent position on that particular aspect, because very critical po yung ating area ng West, o Western Command. So yun yung kung bakit nagkaroon tayong statement na ganyan.
Sir, just to press on my question, so does Vice Admiral Carlos still enjoy the trust and confidence of the AFP leadership?
Right now, Vice Admiral Carlos is relieved from Western Command and placed under the GHQ, under the guidance and supervision of the Office of the Chief of Staff. Office of the Chief of Staff. AFP. So, any other clarification on that matter? If there are none, thank you very much to our commander, to our speaker for the West Philippine Sea. May we call now, sir, the Philippine Air Force for any updates?